Hello everyone, today's video is going to be about WhatsApp and I'll be telling you some important and useful tricks in WhatsApp, important and useful features in WhatsApp. So everyone uses WhatsApp for various purposes. And so when you use WhatsApp, you'll have a lot of people to chat with and you'll have a lot of groups also. If you want to send a message to one particular person, you'll have to find where the chat is in that whole list. You know the chat list, no? You'll have to scroll it, all the way to the bottom. Then you will find it and then you can message. It takes a lot of time. So one important and cool feature is, it's called pin. So if you hold a chat, only for Android users, if you hold a chat, then you will get this pin button. Click on it, so it disappears. You go to the top and you can see that it is pinned there, meaning it will always remain there. You can use it whenever you want, so that you will not have to find it. You know it is always top. So if you want to send a message to that chat, you can go and find it right there, instead of going and scrolling all the way to the bottom. You can use other chats also. You can pin as many chats as you want. For iOS users, it's a different method. You'll have to hold it. It is, I don't know what it is called, but there is a feature for pin itself in WhatsApp. If you are a WhatsApp user, I'm very sure that you will know about the blue tick, which appears in the sender's chat if you see their message. For some reason, if you don't want the blue tick to appear in their mobile, meaning you want to see the message, but you don't want them to know that you have seen that message. Let it be a message, a photo, video, or GIF, anything it is. There is one trick. First of all, what you can do is, if it is a very short message, you can read it in the notification bar itself, so that when you see it in the notification bar, they don't get the blue tick. But say if the message is very long, then only some part of the message will appear in the notification bar. If you want to see the full message, or if the sender sends you a photo or a video, you cannot see it in the notification bar. What you have to do is turn your internet connection off. If you are using mobile data, turn off it, or if you are using Wi-Fi, turn Wi-Fi off. Then you will have to go to WhatsApp and see the message. Then there is one important step. If you don't do this, they will get the blue tick. After you see the message, clear WhatsApp, remove WhatsApp from your background. Don't let it remain there and turn your Wi-Fi or mobile data internet connection on. First, you will have to remove it from the background. Otherwise, they will get the blue tick immediately when you turn your internet on. Most people do till here. They turn their Wi-Fi off or mobile data off and then see the message and immediately turn internet on again and they will get the blue ticks again. So you'll have to see the message, clear it from the background and then turn your internet on. This way your whoever sends you the message will not get any blue ticks. Only next time when you open WhatsApp after turning internet on, they will get the blue tick. For proof, you can see this what I have done here. There is no blue tick there. You can see it is from another mobile. I sent the message from this mobile itself, so you can see there is no blue tick there. 3. Now if you were chatting with some person and then you went offline, they sent you some message and they will get the one timing called last seen near your name in their chat. Last seen tells the timing when you used WhatsApp, when you are online for the last time. For some reason, if you don't want the last seen to appear in their mobile, you can do that. What you have to do is very simple. Go to WhatsApp's home page, click on the three dot symbol, then click on settings page. Then you have to go to account section there, then to privacy section. There you can see last seen. Click on it, you will get three options. Everybody, my contacts, and nobody. By default, it is set to everybody so that everybody can see when you last saw the photo. If you click on my contacts, only the persons who you know personally and you have saved in your contacts can see the your last seen timing. If you click on nobody, nobody can see your last seen. This one is very important. WhatsApp is the most storage or space consuming app. A social media app, it consumes more space than YouTube or Facebook or Instagram or any other social media platform, WhatsApp uses so much of storage, it actually fills your SD card with all the images and photos that anybody sends you. Especially if you are in more than 2 or 3 groups, then you will have a lot of storage problems to deal with. So there is one simple idea. Same here, go to WhatsApp home screen, go to 3 dot, go to settings. Then now you have to go to charts section. There you will have you'll see an option called media visibility. By default it is turned on, you have to turn it off by clicking on it. When you turn the media visibility option off, whatever the photos and videos anybody sends you will not be saved in your mobile gallery. By this you can save a lot of storage. The amount of storage WhatsApp consumes is really very surprising. It uses a lot of storage, and suppose you want only some people's media to be stored in your gallery and not everybody's, then what you have to do is first of all you turn media visibility off. Then you can go to individual charts and turn their media visibility separately on. First turn the media visibility off as mentioned before. Now go to any chart you want to turn media visibility on. Then click on their name. Then go to you can see another option called media visibility. Or I think it is named something different in the latest version of WhatsApp. It used to be, but it is something similar, you will understand that. Now go to media visibility, that one, only from that chart. There you can see default, yes and no. Default, if you set it to default, whatever you have set the main switch, main media visibility switch to, that will be affected. Means if you turn the first media visibility off, even this chart's media will not be saved. If you turn that on, even this will be saved. If you want, you can do it separately on or off by clicking on the respective buttons. Now if you are using the latest version of WhatsApp, obviously, very surely, you will know about the delete for everyone feature. If you send a message to anyone and you want to delete it from their chart too, you click on delete for everyone and they get a message saying you deleted this message. Say by mistake you clicked on only delete for me, then the message is deleted for you. But afterwards you want to delete the message from their chart too, you cannot do anything. No, the message disappears from your chart and you will have no option to delete for everyone. There is one trick, click on delete for me, then you have to send this message to them. But if you like the video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel and share the video among your friends. And if you have any new ideas for me to make a video, please comment them down. I'll surely reply. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned till the next video. Goodbye.